Assalamu alaikum, students. Hope everyone is fine. Your instructor Abdul Rafi here for A-level mathematics. So concept number two, as we were discussing concepts on the Poisson distribution, that is the S2 statistics 29709 topic. Okay, so you need to understand that concept number two in this, after you have got the basic concepts, is basically about the approximations. Okay, so it's basically how do you go from Poisson distribution to the binomial distribution. Okay, so Poisson distribution as an approximation to the binomial distribution. So Poisson distribution approximation, approx, let's write down approx, to binomial distribution. Okay, so hope everyone understands that there is no continuity correction in this. Why? Hope everyone has got the S1 concept of continuity correction. There is no need for continuity correction here, and the reason for this is students, basically both of them are discrete data. Okay, so both of them takes into account the discrete data. So we are now going to look at how we can do the binomial distribution data, we can go to Poisson distribution data. Okay students, so again, our example will be from 2019 topical past papers, that is question number 26, paper 7, variant 2. So it says that on average, which means this is the probability, on average, 1 in 150 components made by a certain machine are faulty. The random variable X denotes the number of faulty components in a random sample of 500 components. Okay, students, so you have been given a random sample of 500 components, and for 2 marks, students, you have to describe fully the distribution of X. So what is going to be the distribution of X? It's very simple. The distribution of X, it's clearly there. If you have S1 concepts very quickly, this is binomial distribution, because sir, we have N and we have the probability as well. Okay, the events is independent, it is occurring single and randomly as well. So we have binomial distribution where N is the number of observations. So here it is, N is 500 components, that is number of faulty components, or the random sample number of components are 500, and you have the probability as well, 1 over 150. The probability is very small as well. Okay, so here we go. The first answer for 2 marks will be that you are going to tell the examiner that this is binomial distribution because you have a random sample of 500 components, and on average the probability is 1 in 150. So out of the 150 components, one is going to be faulty, so that is why P is 1 over 150. Okay, then how you have to state a suitable approximation distribution for X, giving a justification for your answer for 2 marks. So students need to understand very carefully that how do you do the approximation here. Always remember, in this Poisson distribution chapter, if you have your N is large, okay, so let's say your N is large, which means that N is greater than 50. Okay, that is going to be the case here. If N is greater than 50, which means that N is large, okay, so if the conditions are satisfied that N is large, okay, N should be large and your probability should be small. Okay, so probability is small, let's say that probability is 1 over 150 and N is greater than 150, and your NP, when you multiply them for the mean, okay, that we did in the binomial distribution, if your NP, when you multiply N and P, if they are less than 5, okay, so you can convert the binomial distribution approximation to the Poisson distribution. Okay students, hope everyone is getting this, that if your N is large, the larger the value of N is and the smaller the value of P will be, the better the approximation will be, and your NP will be less than 5, N is greater, P is small. So let's see what is our mean coming. Okay, so it's going to be 50. We have N is 500, right? So 500 multiply by 1 over 150 students, it's going to come as, let's keep it in the fraction form. Okay, so 500 divided by 150 is 10 over 3, right? So this is going to be our lambda, or also called the mean as well, in the normal distribution, in the binomial distribution. Okay, so that is very important. So there are 2 conditions, students, that needs to be satisfied in order to the binomial distribution becoming the Poisson distribution. The one of them, and one of them is N should be large, N should be greater than 50, and NP should be less than 5. Okay, so when you move forward, we have using your approximation, use your approximation distribution to find the probability that the sample will include at least three faulty components. So sample should include three faulty samples. So here we go, x is equals to samples of, we can say that faulty components, okay, number of faulty components you can say in the sample, okay, number of faulty components here we have. And you are going to say that now you can write this, that x follows a Poisson distribution that is with the mean of 10 over 3, okay, and you have to find the probability that it will include at least three faulty components. So we have done this type of question already, students, that at least three faulty means that more than three, okay. So x is greater than and equals to three, at least three faulty components will mean that minimum you need three faulty components. And you can go to the infinity, that is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So again, this will take a huge time. So you are going to go the opposite way, students. 1 minus, you are going to say 1 minus, sir, the probability of x is equals to 0, 1 and 2. Okay, not going to include 3 because 3 is part of the answer. You are going to go the complete opposite. What is left? If you need the probability of 3 faulty components at least, that is minimum, kamaskam. And you have to go more than that, that is 3, 4, 5, you have to go that. In order to find this, you subtract the remaining values, that is 0 faulty components, 1 faulty component or 2 faulty components from the 1, and you will get your original answer as well. So let's get work on this. It will be e power negative 10 over 3 into, again you have 0, so the probability of 0 is 1, right? And then you have the probability of 1 is basically the mean, that is 10 over 3, and then you have 10 over 3 2 power divided by 2 factorial, okay. So 10 over 3 into power of 2 divided by 2 factorial, you solve this and whatever you get, you subtract it from 1, so that will be the 1 minus the answer, students, okay. So let's quickly work it out. So what is e power negative 10 over 3 will give me the answer 1 plus 10 over 3. Make sure you are working on the calculator as well for this. So here we go, students, and it is going to be where I'm going to get the answer as 1 minus this answer. I'm getting 0.647, the final answer. This is coming 1 minus 0.35277. And the final answer will be 2-3 significant figure 0.647. So that is how you are going to use the binomial distribution for the Poisson approximation. That is how you're going to approximate. And this is one of the key concepts that will come for 4-5 mark students in the Poisson distribution example questions, okay? So there is answer. Let's do a couple of more examples as well. And students will get this better, the concept number 2, that how do you do Poisson distribution approximation to the binomial distribution? Thank you. Concept number 2, that is basically using the binomial distribution and going to approximation, the Poisson approximation. We have another example, that is basically question number 8 of the topical past papers of 2019, October, November, winter, which says that the random variable X has the distribution B, that is 300, 0.01, which means that N is basically 300, sir. And the probability is going to be 0.01, okay? So N is 300 and probability is 0.01. You have to use a Poisson approximation. Use a Poisson approximation, students, to find the probability between 2 and 6, where 2 and 6 are not included, they are excluded. So you have to find the probability for between the numbers 2 and 6 are not included, students. So first thing will be the condition, the criteria, whether it is matching or not, okay? The condition, the criteria, okay? Again, I'll repeat my point that you need to understand that both binomial and Poisson distribution are discrete variables, so there is no need for continuity correction, okay? There is no need for continuity correction. So we can say that N is large and P is small, okay? So we can definitely say that, sir, N is large and P is small. So you can write this down, that N is large and P is small. So it will be that when you multiply 300 into 0.01, you are going to get 3, that is basically N into P, that is going to be your lambda, also called the mean, Okay, and this is basically NP, okay? If NP is coming less than 5, then you can convert, okay? That's the condition, the criteria. If NP is coming less than 5, so we can judge here that this is definitely coming less than 5. If NP is coming less than 5, here the answer would work, okay? So now you can say that X follows the Poisson distribution, that is 3 lambda value, or 3 is the mean, and you have to find, students, the probability between 2 till 6, which indicates that you understand that 2 and 6 are not included, and you're going to go the way that it will be the probability of X is equals to 3, 4 and 5 that you have to find. Okay, students, hope everyone gets the basic concept understanding. There's a very important concept here, because sir, I can see that they are not asking, this is not included in it. So you don't have to find the probability for 2 and 6. You have to find the probability in between them, that is 3, 4 and 5. And the main thing is that your n into p, that is your mean from the binomial distribution, is less than 5. It is coming 3. So you can easily, the conditions are satisfied. It is easily possible to convert the binomial distribution to Poisson approximation, okay? Why do we use the word of approximation? Because we are going to get an approximate answer, not the exact answer, okay? So here we go, we are going to find the probability. So the answer will be e power minus lambda, that is 3, and multiply by 3 power 3 divided by 3 factorial, plus 3 lambda power of 4 divided by 4 factorial, plus 3 power 5 divided by 5 factorial. Lambda is 3, and you're going to get the answers for this by multiplying. So let's use quickly the calculator to get the answer. E power negative 3 into 3 power 3 divided by 3 factorial, plus 3 power 4 divided by 4 factorial, plus 3 power 5 divided by 5 factorial. And here we go, it's coming as 0.493, okay, students? So here we go, the answer, it is going to come as 0.493, and this is the answer, students. Hope everyone gets this. It is correct with the marking scheme as well. And this was another example on how do you solve the binomial and the Poisson approximation together for concept number 2.